y'all. I'm Jody Wolfborn, a senior curriculum developer at Chef Software, and this is the second video in a series called Getting Started with Habitat. In this video, a practitioner's guide, we'll install the Habitat CLI and configure our workstations to start playing around with some of Habitat's components. For a brief introduction to Habitat and its core components, watch the last video in this series, Core Concepts. From that video, we learned that Habitat is open source software with a bunch of built-in capabilities that allow engineers to automate the building, deploying, and managing of their applications. In this video, we're going to install the Habitat CLI, along with a couple of other tools that will make our lives easier. Habitat works on 64-bit processors. For Linux OSs, it requires kernel 2.6.32 or later. For Mac OS, it requires 10.9 or later. And for Windows users, it requires Win 10 Pro, Enterprise, or Education editions with Hyper-V enabled. We'll walk through the process of installing each of those briefly, following the docs at habitat.sh/docs, in case you want to follow along. For Linux and Mac users, download the Habitat package and extract it to user local bin. Alternatively, on Linux, you can curl this URL with the bash command at the end and do the same thing. And for Mac users, you can do all of this by using Homebrew. Just type brew tap habitat-sh/habitat and then brew install hab. For Mac users, you'll also need to ensure that Docker is installed and running in order to use our Cleanroom Studio in later videos. For Windows users, download the Habitat package from the website and unzip it to somewhere on your C drive, maybe even the Habitat folder. Next, add that folder to your path variable. In PowerShell, you can type $env:path plus equals quotation semicolon C drive and then whatever folder you unzipped it to. Alternatively, you can use Chocolaty to do all of this by installing Chocolaty and opening a command line and typing choco install habitat. To learn more about Chocolaty, you can visit their website. Next, you'll need to download and install Docker for Windows. Go to the Docker website to log into the community and start the download. Once installed, you'll use it to enter the studio. Once everything is installed, open a command line and verify Habitat is working as expected by typing hab --version. Remember this command if you're ever contributing to the open source project or trying to troubleshoot any issues. In addition to giving us the version of Habitat we're running, this command validates that our environment variables are correct and we're able to use the Hab CLI. Now we're ready to set up Habitat. From your command line, enter the command Hab CLI setup. The setup utility will prompt you to configure a default origin, which it'll use when generating new plans and building new packages. If you're working with a large number of origins, you might select No here and define the intended origin later. Otherwise, type Yes and we'll point Habitat at our own origins. Next, we'll need to configure our default origin. If you want to use Habitat for continuous deployment and to collaborate with the Habitat community, the first step will be to create an account on the Package Manager website, bldr.habitat.sh. It's easy. All you need is a valid GitHub account. After you sign in, you'll create a new origin and then copy the public and private keys that are auto-generated. Then, back in the setup wizard, we'll enter our origin name there. If you're working with an already existing origin, you can enter the name here, or if you don't want to create a builder account, you can create your own origin name now. In order to verify trust and sign packages, Habitat needs an origin key. type no here and be sure to paste the keys we copied earlier from Builder or any pre-existing keys into the .hab/cache/keys directory on your workstation. If you didn't create the origin in Builder, type yes to create a new set of keys for your origin, and they'll automatically be placed in the hab cache keys directory for you. If you want to connect your packages with GitHub, paste your GitHub access token in when it prompts you. Choose whether to enable analytics to provide anonymous usage data of the Hab CLI tool back to us, and you're done. If Docker is installed and running, or if you're on Linux, you can now open Habitat plans by entering the Habitat Studio. Just type Hab Studio Enter from a Habitat app directory and start building. Now that your workstation is configured with the Habitat CLI, you can start building, deploying, and managing your applications using a Habitat plan. To walk through a brief tutorial on Habitat, visit learn.chef.io/modules/try-habitat and watch the next videos in this series, The Plan, The Studio, and The Supervisor, to start packaging your application with Habitat, playing around in the studio, and using the supervisor to automate your application development. Until then, I'm Jody Wolfborn. Bye!